Hello, Victor Nygren here. I'm back. It's time to fight a battle that crashed the last time I tried to start it. This is Total War 1942, a mod for Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. It will work on the original Rome Total War, but you can't play ship battles in historical battles or custom battles in the original Rome Total War. You need the Barbarian Invasion for the ship battles to work. But they are only for historical battles and custom battles. Otherwise the game is fully functioning in both versions. It doesn't work in Alexander because there are some differences between the Barbarian Invasion and Alexander. I believe some features were removed in Alexander and other features were added. So Dagovax needed the features of Barbarian Invasion in order to have the ship battles work. Okay, so when you load a save, always click here. That will activate the turn per year script. This mod is using 24 turns per year. Alright. And yeah, we're set to play the battle. Let's see how it will go this time. Fight the battle on the battle map. Yeah, it worked. This war is not an ordinary war. It is a war of the entire Russian people, not only to eliminate the danger hanging over our heads, but to aid all people groaning under the yoke of fascism. Joseph Stalin, 22nd June 1941. Alright, start the deployment. We have a Jeep bodyguard this time and not rifleman. We're not gonna waste the general. We'll move him back. Even if the jeeps have been nerfed, they are still good and way better than the infantry. Alright. I will just retreat with the general actually. Retreat from the battle. Let the army handle the other army. We have some Panzer Ones, we have U-88, heavy bombers, we have the Stuka seen here. We have infantry. So this army were reinforced by infantry units after we lost a few mechanized units in the last battle it were fighting. And we have the BMW motorcycle unit there. We have the bodyguard here. The Tiger One bodyguard. And yeah, we even have some artillery, pack 40 artillery. Alright, the Soviet Yak 9 planes have already started to attack and intercept our troops here, firing at our troops on the ground. We also have some Soviet tanks over here, both MS-1s and T-34s. They're light tanks and they're medium tanks. On this side we have some additional tanks, T-34 medium tanks, both units. No, this is an MS-1 light tank. So they had like two units of medium tanks and two units of light tanks there. Here we have a larger force, and our U-88 bombers have already reached them and are about to drop their bombs on them. I hope they won't be shot down. And I believe we can also risk shooting them down ourselves. The Tiger One tanks, for example, have some powerful projectiles. They might actually shoot down our own planes instead of the enemy. I believe that happened in the last battle. So they have lots of infantry in this army, which is good for us. Infantry is usually worthless. We have some assault rifles there, assault infantry, mostly riflemen. St- Dukas are bombing them already. And as for our U-88 heavy bombers, haven't seen them drop any bombs, but maybe that will happen soon. One of them seemed to be slightly glitched in the air there, moving around. Alright, I wonder why they are not dropping any bombs then. It's time for you to drop your bombs. Alright, let's move on. We have their infantry here moving up towards our troops. Here we have a pack 40 crew without the actual artillery. Their planes are firing at our troops on the ground. We didn't have any fighter planes this time. They still seem to have lost a few of their planes, thanks to tanks and other stuff. Alright. So they attack us from both sides with tanks, and our tanks there just fled. Post the battle, I don't know what that was. So the Tiger 1 unit actually fled, the general. And our Vesp artillery, we had two of them. And pack 40s, they lost too. I don't know how this happened. But it seems our army is already defeated. Probably because we were attacked from both sides. So our artillery didn't get any chance to fire back. And our tanks were surrounded from all sides. Right, only our Stuka tactical bombers and heavy bombers are doing a good job, but alone they will probably not be enough. So I fear we just lost the army here, and one of the generals, fortunately we did retreat the other general, the one we got after winning a battle, I believe. Alright, but the historical general is dead. I'm sure he is, or he managed to flee as well. Maybe he survived. So the Soviet army surrounded us and took us out before we could get a proper position to fire our artillery and stuff. They lost two costly Vesp artillery units there before they even got to fire. That's the weakness of the artillery, that they are very weak against tanks, in the sense they can take out tanks in one shot, but if the tanks get too close, they will just steam over their crew, because unfortunately artillery needs crew in rotary war. So that means the crew will all run away or die, and then you have lost the artillery. That's why tanks are better, unless you have a lot of artillery and a lot of tanks or planes. In the late game, I believe most armies will have a focus on planes, so the air superiority will be very important. However, you also need tanks. Infantry will not be that needed. I know they will use assault infantry instead of riflemen. So we had a clear defeat here. We lost the battle. Killed 151, they killed 227. It wasn't a good result this time. I had hoped they would do better. Once more a red fire blows deeply upwards. The factory will do no more work for Herr Churchill. Tomorrow morning, Coventry will lie in smoke and ruins. Joseph Goebbels, Minister of Propaganda, September 1940. Alright. So we lost the battle. And we have another battle here, but I want them to be the ones invading. We just merged the units. We have 5 Panzer IVs left. I won't disband them. We have 1 Vesp artillery. I will still keep it. 12 scout snipers could be of use. I don't know, but 6 SS infantry is not that good. We have General Heinz Guderian survived, but he has only 5 units of Jeeps, of Tiger 1s left. Soviet armies outside of the Romanian city of Odessa as well. City they conquered in the beginning of the war that used to be theirs, but they had given it away to the Soviets, I believe, because of pressure in like 1940 or something. Anyway, they got the settlement after they joined Hitler in invading the Soviet Union, and now the Soviets are on their way to take it back. Our general, the one we got after battle, Felix Battle, he fled here. He has 15 units. So he fled to Romania. Oh, I regret attacking Tobruk with Rommel and his army. We could have used Rommel on the Eastern Front. I also regret trying to play historically, because the fleet here is needed to move the troops from Africa to the Eastern Front. You know, in real history, Erwin Rommel, the leader of the Africa Corps of Germany, he also led the Italians. But in this game, the Italians are their own faction, so we can't lead the Italian armies. That means he's too weak to have any chance of winning in Africa without the Italian armies. So the best thing we can do is to retreat our troops to Europe and use them against the Soviets. But I've already lost the bigger part of the tank force here. We only have infantry left and artillery and Rommel himself. And my plan is to move them, but I'm afraid the British or the Free French might besiege us before we can leave, because the fleet, the U-boat fleet that we need to move the troops, is over here, and it will take at least 3 turns before they reach, Tunis first. We need to evacuate this unused force as well. Here it has some tanks, 2 Panzer 1s and 1 Panzer 4, and they have some Pack 40, Stokes Mortar, Scout Snipers, Assault Infantry and BMW Motorcycle. We need to evacuate them together with the infantry here. We will give Tunis to Italy, I don't care. Then it will be up to Italy to defend Africa. Same with Benghazi, we will give it to Italy. But in order to be able to give it to Italy, we need that diplomat that we are recruiting in Berlin currently. And in order to move the troops, we need the fleet. And it will take some time before we can reach Tunis and then go all the way to Benghazi. So I'm afraid we might actually be invaded before that happens. The United States might actually attack our army here, and Britain might attack here. So I am afraid I did a mistake moving the fleet all the way to the Atlantic. We should have evacuated both the armies to fight in the Eastern Front, because the Soviet Union has too many armies and we are in need of any troops we can get. And without the Italian troops here, we can't hold the area for long. So they are better used on the Eastern Front. The same with Heracleion. I plan on giving Heracleion to Turkey, a neutral faction that has a grudge towards the Greeks. So giving Heracleion to the Turks is a plan, and I will also give Athens to Turkey. That way Bulgaria and Italy will be busy with the Turks, because Turkey is not an ally and could very well be an enemy of theirs. That would prevent them from focusing on my areas here, so I could move the armies from Greek and African territory to the Eastern Front, because I need that. I just lost the great army there, and I don't know how long these armies will be able to hold out, so I need those armies moved. We don't need African regions, we don't need Greece. I might actually even abandon Yugoslavia and this area here, Zagreb. As for other regions, I believe we should move most of the army in Norway and in Denmark as well, and here we actually have a fleet, so we can move them, but we can't move them this turn. We will destroy the Soviet fleet, and then we will move them here to move the troops. We could probably move the troops through Sweden, which is also true, because Sweden allowed Germany to move troops through their country. We need a few troops to hold Norway, but far from all of these. We have 5 units, we will move them. And then we have another 5 here, so half an army at least could reinforce them. We don't need 4 units, I believe. Let's move another one, maybe could leave 2 units there. Or even most of the army will be moved. Don't need more than one in Oslo, even if they revolt. This way we need a full army, and then we'll send them with the ships all the way here to Riga, to the port of Riga, and join the battle against this army. And Leonid Petrov there. Alright. We have some battles to fight first. They will attack there, I won't attack. We have this battle to fight. So their army. 2 riflemen, bodyguards, and 4 units of T-34 medium tanks. The other army had another 2 riflemen, bodyguards, and then they have 2 units of... they have like 10 units of T-34 medium tanks. We are at a disadvantage. Right. Let's see here. We have room for 3 units there. Of course we're gonna reinforce the army. And attack. What does it look like? Have some infantry, but they also have some planes. 2 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighters, 2 Vesp artillery units. They have at least 2 jeeps, and they have 2 units of BMW motorcycles. They have they have 1 unit of Panzer IVs and 2 units of Panzer Ones. The army is not that good compared to their army with lots of T-34 tanks, but we have planes. Alright, we still risk losing that battle. We have no choice, we will attack them, I believe. It's pretty equal in statistics. We are at slight disadvantage. Say before the battle in case it will crash. Alright, start the battle on the battlefield. Yes, didn't crash. I say that the bombing of the Abbey was a mistake. It only made our job more difficult, more costly in terms of men, machines and time. Lieutenant General Mark Clark, commander of the US 5th Army in 1944, after the bombing of Monte Cassino, probably in Italy. Start deployment. So loose formation. So the reinforcements are arriving. But where are the Soviet army? Here we have some of them. Lots of tanks. I will just place my infantry at defense, and they are at fire at will, so they will fire whenever the enemy is close. They will be owned because they are infantry. Now the full army here with all the planes and stuff have already started to fire on the Soviet army on the ground that spawned very close to their army. The bigger army of Soviet troops with both tanks and infantry. Look at this force. It's not a small land on me. They don't have any planes. So my hope is on the planes that they will be able to win this. We had some mechanized troops too, but most of our army is comprised of infantry, so... Panzer 1s, they are not as good as the T-34s, unfortunately. Panzer 4s are similar quality, but we had only one unit and they have a lot of T-34s. Fortunately, the planes are better than the tanks, so that's why they are the hope, but they don't have that much health. See, they are shot down quite easily if the numbers of tanks are many. So I'm afraid we'll lose. Still, we will fight the battle. Here we have some BMW motorcycles and Waffen-SS infantry. Alright, here are the Panzer IVs, the best of our tanks in this battle. They are on equal terms with the T-34s. They might have worse statistics or better statistics, I don't know. But they have the same medium shells that they fire. Well, the Panzer I's only have small shells, so they are not as strong at all. The type of shell greatly affects how effective they are in the battle. Zoom in on the minimap. You can see more clearly what's happening here. So they have lost a lot of their tanks already. Our infantry are running forward here. We have two units of Vesp artillery here. Wonder if they will start to fire soon. They are firing. Good that they got the chance to fire this time. They are also very good against tanks and planes if they hit. They just have the weakness of being in need of infantry in order to work. Unlike in real history where they were without infantry. Alright. So the battle is going on here. Look at the tank carcasses here of T-34 tanks. Some jeeps, the general in his jeep there. I think we have two generals in this battle. Two German generals, and then they had two Soviet generals as well. They had four Soviet generals actually. They had huge forces here. They have the second army here. Lots of infantry and tanks. So they have like two waves. And while our army seemed to be able to handle the first wave pretty equally, they still seem to be hard pressed. I'm afraid they won't be able to handle the second army. They've lost their planes already. It went over expectations against the first army. The motorcycles are broken. What is this? We have some infantry here. My infantry. Only four left. They were killed by the tanks as expected. A little side show there. All our planes have been shot down. That's unfortunate. Our cars are firing their machine guns at the enemy. Still have a few planes. Their entire second army is soon to steamroll our army here. We have mostly infantry. Some BMVs here too. We had two units, I believe, of BMW motorcycles. Yeah, they won against the first Soviet army. Good job, soldiers. However, Soviet Union has an entire second army with lots of tanks, so I'm not entirely sure we will survive that assault. No. We'll see. Still needed to attack because they have too many armies. Waiting would just mean they will attack with more armies. this was the best like option. Otherwise there would be even more in the battle. Unit route, being a motorcycle, hero of death, Captain Reinhold. Just my captain died. And he doesn't matter. Fallen here, so our army with one unit of riflemen has been defeated. Alright. Look at the battle here. We managed to defeat their first army. Now the second army is moving closer to us. We are about to face that army. Having dealt with their first army, the jeeps are moving up first. Two generals, bodyguards. Alright. And the infantry here. Riflemen. Assault infantry. Even some Panzer I's are still alive, and the SS infantry there. The SS seem to be very effective. I looked at the statistics previously, and they killed like 41 of the enemy units, while other units didn't manage as good, so they are like the elite infantry. Very effective. Alright. They also had a lot of infantry, fortunately, but their tank numbers are better than ours. And our tanks are not as good as these T-34, that's why I'm worried. These are comparable to the MS-1s, unfortunately. One got taken out there. They are doing their best to kill their troops there. Driving them over and firing at the tanks. Had a few of them left. Let's see how the battle will progress. Hopefully we won't lose, but looking at the statistics here, it's very equal. 28%, 29% of allies killed, 41% enemies killed. So we are leading, but as they have more tanks, I fear the worst. We'll see. If we're lucky, we might actually manage to save the city. Kiev, I believe. Our infantry troops here are moving up towards the front. They are still firing at us from their tanks. We also have lots of infantry still moving up. Their infantry numbers are bigger than ours. I believe their units of infantry are way more than our units. They have more troops in a unit of infantry than we have when they are at their full strength. And the statistics of the infantry units are probably similar. Just their numbers are greater. Alright, a very equal battle, even though they had two armies and I had one. But, yeah. Doesn't look good. We seem to only have infantry left here. Different types of infantry. So they might be able to like take out some of their units, but as soon as those tanks are starting to roll, they will drive over our troops there. Oh, we have some scout snipers here, laying in on the ground, firing. We have two units of snipers. Assault infantry. And now the tanks are moving towards the infantry, towards the snipers. Not good. Been driven over. Alright. And there they broke. The rest of the army is now also being driven over. This is what I was afraid of. We had too few mechanized units to be able to win against their second army. They did a very good job too. They took out a lot of their troops and one of their armies. A lot of their second army also were destroyed, but in the end, their tank numbers were too many. T-34 D34 numbers are simply too great. So it became a loss after all. I believe Kiev is lost. So we have no army left to defend it. We sent out 3 riflemen units from the city as well. We have a general in the city, but besides him, we don't have much. Maybe some of these troops will be able to retreat to the city. They will probably die defending Kiev. So units routes. Our artillery is still firing, but now the crew here are being fired at, so they are retreating. They had a good position here, so they probably killed a lot of their troops there, but now they seem to be all but defeated. The Vesp artillery. The worst of the 3 different mobile artillery types. You need to build some new buildings in order to get the better stuff. The Hummel and the Givi Tiger. But I don't want to have anything from the wrong year earlier, so we won't get anything too soon. So they won the battle! Alright, average defeat. Our army. Men deployed. Riflemen. We had 70 riflemen. A full unit there. They killed 1 only and 0 remaining. Then we had George von Kutchler, the general in charge, in command of the Great Army. They killed 543. That was actually good. And only have 185 left that fled. Probably fled to the city. Enemy armies. Dmitry Ivanov had 538 men and killed 441, so that was also very good. And they have most of their army left, 427 out of 538. Then they had their second army under Nikolai Ivanov. Most of their generals are named Ivanov, have the Ivanov surname. Alright, they had 722 men. Killed only 69, that was actually bad, and 358 remaining. They probably restored some of their fleeing troops, and some of their troops were healed after the battle. But I believe this is the army that we defeated, and the other army managed to win the battle, so they restored some of their troops. Alright, continue. You think of the lives which would have been lost in an invasion of Japan's main islands. A staggering number of Americans, but millions more of Japanese. And you thank God for the atomic bomb. Comment of one Marine in the Pacific. Yeah. We're back on the map. It looks very bad here. We are going to destroy the trader. We have dirt roads here. Can't destroy any more here. So this was the battle outside of Minsk, not Kiev. We have other forces protecting Kiev, but both cities, Kiev, the capital of modern day Ukraine, and Minsk, the capital of modern day Belorussia, They are in a very bad position. 9 riflemen left. Don't think we need riflemen, unfortunately. Not 5 of them. Could keep the general there. Keep the rest of the units. They will have to hold on. Heroic death. George von Kutchler died. Alright, there's nothing more we can do. We will click next turn. The Americans have attacked the army outside of Alger. I was afraid they would do that. So we will start the battle and then we will retreat. If I retreat on the map, they will probably be attacked again and can't retreat. But if I retreat in the battle, they most likely will retreat all the way to Tunis, which is what I want. So we'll do that. Let's save first. Because I want to retreat this army if we can. Fight battle on the battle map, yes. It would be a wonderful thing for all of humanity if both peoples would renounce force against each other forever. The German people are ready to make such a pledge. Adolf Hitler, 14th October 1933. I wonder what people he was talking about. That wasn't said. Alright. Alright, so here we have the army. Too valuable to be lost against the superior American army. Let's move them back here. Start the battle. And then we will retreat the entire army. There's no general leading this army. So the army is retreating. Corsairs of the Americans. Booing. Let's see here. What is that? Booing something, heavy bombers, I don't remember the name. Have some American troops here. Stokes mortars. And the battle is over! We fled the battlefield. Never has a military operation been undertaken so much against the will of the commanders. Count Ciano, Italian foreign minister, commenting on the Italian advance into Egypt. September 1940. Yeah, the commanders didn't really want to participate in the World War II. Alright. So the Soviet Union is finally assaulting Kyiv here. Or they are attacking the army outside of Kyiv actually. They have a lot of troops. Let's retreat. A new general! Of course we will have a new general. He spawned in Minsk and we could use him there. We needed some reinforcements there. So in Brest we have infantry. Could send reinforcements to Minsk. This army will move to Riga. To defend the Baltic there. Well, our general here is going to move to Belgrade. We are -556 now in income. Faction announcements. New family member Ulrich Alterbung. Marriage celebrations Walter Graf. Retinue expands Ferdinand Furbringer. Alright. Alliance announced. French state Vichy are now allied to the Italian Empire. So they had broken their alliances previously because they were allied in the start of the game. Agent recruited Berlin. We have a diplomat. Finally. Then we have a construction complete. We have the sandbag wall outside of Frankfurt. Italian armies on the border. They've actually entered the area of Zagreb. That's not good. You're going to betray me or something. So in Berlin we have a diplomat, good. We won't be able to reach the Italians this turn. We did. Good. To use the total diplomacy, we need to click on the question mark, and then we will need to click on show me how. Now they won't be able to refuse our demands. I believe they already have maps of the entire world in the Second World War, so we will get their map information. We will also give them our map information. Then, as they are Italy, we will promise to attack Soviet Union, and we expect them to also attack the Soviet Union, and then we will give them some regions actually, even if they betray us. We'll give them Tunis. No, we won't give them Tunis, we will give them Benghazi, I believe. So, that's it. We need Tunis for now, because our army is moving there. Managed to flee here. So, they are back at Tunis. Perfect, my plan worked there. Seem to have lost a few units by fighting the battle, too. I'm still afraid that the Americans will get to us and besiege the city before we can, you know, leave. We have a free French fleet here and a Vichy French fleet. One ship against one ship, alright. The army here try to reach Tunis, so we are moving through the Italian lands here with Rommel and his group. He gave Benghazi to the Italians and they got an entire army. Interesting. We got an entire army, yes, thank you. Alright. So the Italians will be more able to protect Benghazi than we were. Because we had lost most of the army anyway. Alright. So the war will continue between the Italians and the British and the Free French there. We need a fleet to return to Tunis as soon as possible. Can't see how many turns they are from reaching. I believe we could move there now. So they didn't get further this turn. U-boat fleet is the fleet we need to evacuate all the troops. The Americans, they might actually strike before they reach there. We also want this army to reinforce, so the entire force can leave. So we have 11 troops there, and we have 6 here. That means that we have 17 troops in total, so we lack 3 until we have a full army there. Where the Italians will attack me. We have 3 infantry units, 2 infantry units. Let's move some planes to Zagreb. Some tanks. Some BMW motorcycles. Unit of assault infantry there. Maybe a unit of Stokes mortar. And another unit of Panzer I planes, tanks. Alright, and yeah. We don't need both those, we can have more tanks in Zagreb actually. And one unit of Waffen SS there as well. So, much better, and yeah, that's it for now. have been increased. You also know that Italy owns areas down here. They own Mogadishu and Addis Ababa. I believe Addis Ababa is the capital of Ethiopia, or in those days it was Abyssinia. And Mogadishu, I think that's the capital of Somalia, actually. And then they are holding this area, Tripoli, capital of Libya. That's the areas Italy owns in Africa. And they have their own areas, and this area, it is probably Albania's capital, Tirana. Alright. Portuguese are still outside of Bordeaux there. The Vichy French have withdrawn their troops, which is good. And we have Italians here. So the Soviet Union have taken Kharkov from the Italian Empire. No, it says they are still allied. So I'm not sure actually what the situation is there. The Italians have a force here. The General Virgilio de Campo and a unit of cavalry, riflemen on horses with rifles. Better than the riflemen, as they are cavalry. Alright, they are besieging Kiev. Captain Alexei and Pavel Ivanov. Let's combine our forces here and move this army. Leave it still be used there. We move them there too, in case they attack and it would not be included. I want it to be included in the battle. We should reinforce on the battlefield. So our defenders, Walter Busch and Vita Jeep Bodyguard and four units of riflemen, they will be reinforced by the remnants of Heinz Guderian and his army. Fleet here, our fleet under Admiral Friedrich will sink the Soviet fleet. Clear victory. Good. I was correct in my assumption that it wouldn't crash. I have fixed that issue. Fleet are moving towards the army there. The Norwegian force, or rather our force from Norway, are being sent towards the fleet. We have an army that can move here as well. We'll move them as well into Sweden. They are currently using the railroads here, railways in Sweden. So they have a deal with Sweden too. Move to through their lands here. The Norwegian troops and the Danish troops, or rather the occupation forces of Norway and Denmark. And they are going to be shipped to Riga's port here and assist against the Soviet Union. They are desperately needed there. We have a new army of Soviet troops outside of Minsk. We have a few generals here. Gerd von Rundstedt, he could be retreated, I believe. He's a known general. Ernst Dissel. I actually want to retreat him too. The rest will fight to the death with the General Oscar battle here. We have some infantry here that could help out. let's increase the army there. We'll move up the SS infantry, they are good. Alright, good against enemy troops. We will leave the rest as defense forces in Warsaw and Brest. I believe Brest is a Polish city as well. Alright. They had some armies there to scare off the Italians. As we can see, they clearly wanted to attack Zagreb. Hope we will have placed enough units here now so they won't betray us. We have about equal forces in both cities now. Prague is weaker. We have München too, heavily defended. In case the Vichy French or the Italians will attack there. Only Prague is weak. And also they are surrounding Kyiv there. Yeah. So what now? We will build some stuff. I believe I had a fleet here as well. Right. Let's try to combine it with the other fleet. Couldn't go reach there this time. And now it's time to build. We are still building a port in Berlin. Yeah, we are still building in many places. In Oslo we can't build anything. In Hamburg. Civil headquarters. We get a spy. Actually, we need an airstrip. I will build that in Hamburg, so we can build Stukas and Messerschmitt 109s. I believe they will come in handy later in the war. In Frankfurt, we also need an airstrip. Planes are of great importance if we are going to have a chance. Some airstrips in Amsterdam as well, and in Brussels, and in Paris, and in Rouen, in Bordeaux. I managed to click the wrong button. Alright. Need to get airfields almost everywhere. We won't build anything there in Kyiv. In Kyiv, I think. Maybe we could build a recruit a assault infantry unit there. In Minsk, we could use another unit of riflemen. And here a plane. We're going to give it away anyway. And for now we will recruit some assault infantry. Brest could use a rifleman unit. Riga, we could use a scout sniper. Athens, we could use a scout sniper. Belgrade, we could use a rifleman unit. War, so we could use another diplomat. Actually, we only have one, we need more. Zagreb, we could use a scout sniper. Vienna, we could use a rifleman unit. Prague, yeah, I believe in Prague we could actually use some I believe the Messerschmitts are better than the bombers. They are less likely to die. Let's build some Messerschmitt 109s there. We need planes. In Stettin we could use a Stuka strategic bomber instead. Tactical bomber. In Copenhagen could just recruit a rifleman unit. And in Berlin itself we have no trucks, and we have no assassins or spies. I believe we will build a anti-aircraft track, because we have no such units. And München, we could use a Panzer IV. We need more tanks. In Oslo we could use assault infantry. In Hamburg we could use scout snipers. And in Frankfurt, I believe Frankfurt we could use a Panzer IV unit. Amsterdam we could use a assault infantry. And in Brussels we could use assault infantry. So we won't recruit snipers everywhere. In Paris we could use a Stokes mortar artillery unit. In Rouen we could use assault infantry. In Bordeaux we had only the choice of riflemen. And that's it. We're done with recruitment and the building this time. And I believe we can't do anything more this turn. I don't think our diplomat can move anymore. Nope. We want him to probably move slightly closer to the areas here. The Baltic. Right, next turn. Soviets attacked, as expected, at Kyiv. They have Pavel Ivanov with a starting army of 5 T-34 tanks and a bodyguard of riflemen. Then he has Captain Alexei backing him up with two units of riflemen, 1 unit of assault infantry, 1 unit of scout snipers, 3 units of riflemen, 1 unit of MS-1 tanks, 1 unit of T-34 tanks, and Yak 9 fighter plane. So our army under Walter Busch only have a jeep bodyguard and 4 units of riflemen. We are totally not ready to face this. We have about equal numbers of infantry, but they have better infantry, and the jeeps can't handle tanks and planes that well. Then our other army is actually weaker in terms of numbers, but has some mechanized stuff still. Alright, I didn't remember if I saved, so let's save now and then we will fight the battle in the battlefield. We're forced to attack by an army of the United Soviet Socialist Republics. Alright, Hinskiderian's remnant force will back us up. This is a battle for cities, so it will be a new type of custom settlement. Alright, fight the battle on the battle map. With Malta in enemy hand, the Mediterranean route would be completely closed to us. This tiny island was a vital feature in the defense of our Middle East position. General Hastings, Ismay, 1942. Start deployment. As you can see, this is a city. I have never played in a city before. The roads are modern and it's larger than the large town, of course. But, and it has the Siegfried Line defenses here, the best towers, and the modern roads. Pretty cool to see the troops standing on modern roads. Looks very, very modern. So we have infantry and jeeps in the city. Degovax Syrianus, the main creator of the mod, he made new routes and paths for this city as well. He did that for the town and the large town and the city. Well, the large city is using vanilla styled paths and roads. Alright, so this city is unique in how its layout is, but it required more work in order to make it work, and also he has a lot of unique buildings here. If he runs into a limit adding settlements for the United States and the others, like Japan, China, Turkey, etc., then he might be forced to change the city and make the buildings less different. But as we can see, this settlement, unlike the large city, has a lot of different buildings with different size and different style, etc., which is pretty cool. It also has some unique features like street lights and the cars and stuff. All of these things count as buildings and might be removed in the future, because they might need to be removed in order to open up slots for other factions. But currently there's only German custom settlements in the game. So, and also we have some vanilla buildings, because the unique buildings here that are still vanilla, they haven't been replaced yet. So this is the city. We have a river there. I think we will move the general to the center there. And I will group the riflemen, put them on loose formation in defense, and place them at the center. So we have placed our defenders at the center. Alright, they could be placed under AI control. Let's take a look at the enemy. We have one Soviet arm here with their siege ram truck. And then we have some snipers driving the ram there, or the truck. We have the T-34s, the MS-1s, the Yak-9 fighter planes in the air, moving around. And that's their first army, their weaker one. Then we have their stronger army on the other side, with like 5 units of T-34 tanks and 1 unit of rifleman bodyguard. And the bodyguard, as you know, have more numbers than the ordinary rifleman unit. Our reinforcement under Heinz Guderian will probably show up soon. So start the battle. Yeah, he spawned next to their army. Next to their real army. I believe this is the stronger army after all, even though they had a lot of infantry. They had planes too. So we had some Panzer IVs still remaining, mostly infantry, some BMW motorcycles, and especially we had a few Stuka planes, tactical bombers still in the air. And we had the Heinz Guderian himself with a Tiger bodyguard, but only 2 Tigers remain. 3 Tigers. 3 Tiger 1s. Alright. So we have some backup there. We will see if it will be destroyed. Firing their projectiles. The cruiser barrel, one projectile. Stukas dropping bombs at the enemy. They had fighter planes, that's not good for our bombers. Fortunately, we had the bodyguard himself here. Tiger 1 tanks are not bad. So the battle is currently going on outside of the city, between Heinz Guderian and his troops, remnants after the loss in the previous month, or whatever, previous week maybe. Alright, Good that we had some bombers here. Taking out their tanks. They're actually very good against tanks if they drop their bombs on them. One hit will kill a tank. No, they took down. Or was that the airplanes? No, it was my plane. One of my Stukas got taken down. And another one went down. That's because they have fighters and they are good against bombers. So while our bombers are good against their tanks, they are not good against their fighter planes. And we'll probably all be shot down because of the fighter planes. So our hope is the bodyguard, the Inspirarian himself, the Tiger One tanks. We have some great projectiles. What is happening on the other side? Soviet Union have entered the outskirts of the city with their infantry. Assault infantry. Our bodyguard here is at the center, but we sent out the other troops. Alright, in the city. We have some T-34 tanks arriving on the roads here. Not good. Our infantry are standing on a vanilla glitched area. Silver Surfer area there. Well, the Soviet Union have sent in some riflemen from the front here. Our Stukas are still in the air, dropping bombs on their troops. Their fighter planes are also in the air. Might take them out. Right, we had a broken Panzer IV there. It was broken from the start. Assault infantry moving in. And Skiderian himself. Some SS infantry. BMV motorcycles firing machine guns at the enemy. The battle here is not over yet. Well, the city is also being invaded from the other side. Our infantry are fighting their infantry and defeated their riflemen there. Good job, infantry. Problem is, you have T-34s arriving from the other side. You can't stand against these guys. Alright. We also have had a lot of tanks coming the roads from the other side, and the infantry won't be able to do anything against them. We kept our general on his jeep here. So the troops are moving forward here, scaring away their infantry, missing out entirely on their tanks. They have still infantry on the field here. We have the Stuka in there. We have some fighters. Two Jack 9 fighters. The rest have been taken down. And we lost the Stuka. We have no planes left. However, our Tiger 1s are still firing. With Heinz Guderian himself in one of the tanks. We have the BMV motorcycles firing at the enemy. And the broken Panzer IV driving over the enemy. The BMV motorcycles are also driving right through the enemy there while firing simultaneously with their machine guns. Still fear that the fighter planes are going to take them down in the end. They fire some heavy shots there from... That's our Tiger I tanks. Firing beams there. I hope they take out the planes. Alright, cruiser barrel 1 projectiles to the Tiger 1 tanks. Good job. General, now our infantry are fighting their infantry here, and we have the numerical advantage. That's not a rifleman unit, I believe it's an assault infantry unit of the Soviet Union. And our troops are victorious against their infantry, but their tank army is now closing in on us. They're coming here. Huge forces of tanks, T-34 tanks, coming from both sides. Already firing at our jeeps at the center. Actually, I will have to place the jeep in AI control. So they can fire back. Not good. Most of them were taken out without having the ability to fire back because their reach wasn't far enough. Couldn't reach the tanks. Now they are firing back at least. Jesus Christ. Troops, back to the city. You're losing the center. The victorious German infantry are now moving back towards the city plaza because the Soviet T-34 tanks have taken the plaza and they will win in 2 minutes 34 seconds. So we need to move there fast. I can't control Heinz Guderian. He's still busy fighting the Yak 9 plane here. We have one unit of BMW motorcycles left still. And some infantry of Soviet Union are still around. We have some snipers here, still firing. I wonder if they will take out Heinz Guderian himself. Yeah, I think he died. Enemy general dead. Captain Alexei, no one cares about the captain. Walter Busch died. And Heinz Guderian is reinforcing, of course. We need help in the center. They don't have time to be there anymore. So our infantry are trying to reach the center. They are now facing the tanks. Soviet Union are driving right through them. Yeah, not good. Put under AI control. Our infantry are good against their infantry, but will now probably be beaten by their tanks here. Which means the city has fallen. Kiev has fallen. They are now broken. Not good. Love how the tanks move on the roads and stuff. Looks so good. All our jeeps at center were taken out. How is it going over here? We have some snipers in the grass here. They won't be able to stop. Oh, we are no longer losing. We have two units of snipers still firing. They have all their troops left. Some of the Soviets decided to leave the plaza, so we didn't lose. Now they are back. They left again. We have one unit of BMW motorcycles firing machine guns at the enemy as well. But mostly it's two units of scout snipers. Where is Heinz Guderian himself? I thought I had a general here somewhere. We'll need to zoom in on the battle. Because I don't like not knowing what happened to Heinz Guderian. He's dead. I didn't get such a message, I believe. Unless I managed to click on it without reading it. Alright. Have a unit over here as well that haven't entered the city. The bodyguard. The rifleman bodyguard of the Soviet Union. The second army there. Alright. Our infantry is broken and most of them have been killed now. As they were trying to reach the city. Massacre of our troops there. I can't find Hans Guderian. He's probably dead. I see some carcasses here of Tiger tanks. There were only three of them. So yeah, I think Hans Guderian is dead. Alright, let's continue the battle. Our BMW motorcycle is still going on a rampage against their remaining troops on this side of the battlefield, outside of the city, shooting them as they run away and driving them over. When they move this slowly, they are actually walking. They can run too, and that's when they run fast, like now. Alright, our snipers are now running. We have 5 units of snipers there. They can't reach the plaza, they will be killed by the tanks. We have 11 additional snipers running there. Our only hope is the BMW motorcycle unit driving right towards the plaza. It will face a lot of T-34 tanks in the city. Full speed ahead, BMW motorcycle. Alright, see how it will fare toward against the tanks, the Soviet Union. Soon it will drive right over all the poor troops here that died. Or 3 units of riflemen, or 4 units of riflemen, all dead due to those tanks. 2 minutes until we lose the battle. Statistics: 87% allies killed, 43% enemies killed. We have clearly lost the battle no matter what. Our snipers are also trying to reach the city, but they are not close to the city yet. They are about to enter another part of the city. I see that on their minimap. No! The tanks shot down our BMW motorcycles. Only the snipers left. They are trying to fire from a distance. That's good that they can fire from a long distance, but they only have 1 minute 14 seconds until they lose. So I believe the battle is lost. Even if they can get to fire at them and kill at least some of them, hopefully. So the Union is sending out T-34 tanks here, firing at the snipers. Come on, snipers! You're our only hope to protect Kyiv. The tanks come rolling down the streets, driving over the snipers of our first unit and right into the second unit of snipers. Before they could do anything, they are broken. Alright, and there they broke. And the Soviet Union won this battle and took back Kyiv, the Ukrainian capital. Yeah. And how many did we kill? 43%, and they killed 91%. Still an interesting battle and a really cool city. But it was impossible to win. Alright, and all of them died. Clear defeat. Walter Bush had 297 men, killed 142, and 9 remaining. It was pretty good actually for such a small force. And Hans Guderian, the known general, the historical general, had 180 men remaining. He killed 174, very good. And 14 remaining after the battle, so there were a few still remaining. Ah, I see outside of the city, maybe that's a tiger tank. I can't click there anymore, we need to move there manually. Shame he couldn't enter the city with the tiger tank. Ah, he was dead, but the minimap thinks he's still alive, alright. Then we had some others here. I believe it's a bug probably that makes the map think they are alive. They are all dead. Alright, and Pavel Ivanov killed 233 and have 322 remaining out of 361 troops. That was very good. And the other army with all the tanks, etc. They, I believe this was the tank army, and then the other army with 377 troops. Killed 202. So their armies killed more than mine, alright. Let's look at the detailed statistics too. Alright, we're done here. Kiev is lost. Fuck, it crashed probably. So I will have to replay the battle. Might end differently if I replay it, but hopefully it will end similarly. Hate when this happens. It's worse.